Hi, I'm Corinne from D's, and today we're going to go over jewelry basics. Some of the tools that you use in jewelry making are needle nose pliers. They're flat on the inside. Round nose pliers. They're round all the way around. Wire cutters. Flat nose pliers. They're actually flat and squared off at the tip. Memory wire shears. These would be used for cutting memory wire or for larger gauged wires. And crimp bead pliers. Other items you might use in jewelry making would be wrapping wire, head pins, which have a stop at the end to stop your beads, eye pins, which already have a pre-made loop on one end, crimp beads, which you can use to stop the beads at the end of a bracelet, bead stringing wire, which is used for bracelets and is flexible. Your crimp beads will actually match the size of your bracelet, and it should say on your package of stringing wire which crimp bead you should use for your wire. Bead stringing wire also comes in different numbers of strands. The more strands your bead stringing wire has, the more flexible it will be, and it will be a little stronger. There is a benefit to that, but if you're using lighter weight beads, it's okay to use this 7-strand package. If you're using heavier beads, you may want to go to a package that has 19 strands or more. Next, we will talk about making a loop with a head pin. You will place your bead on the head pin. You will use your needle nose pliers to make a 90 degree bend as close to the bead as you can get. After you've made the bend, you will then use your wire cutters to clip off your excess, leaving about a half of an inch. Hold on to your excess wire so it doesn't go flying across the room. Then use your round nose pliers, starting at the very end of the wire, but a little ways up on your round nose pliers, and twist your wrist to turn the wire. You will then need to adjust your grip and turn it the rest of the way until the wire touches. Once you have your loop, you can then use that loop to attach it to an ear wire or use the bead as a charm, and then you could have a charm bracelet or earrings or any number of other jewelry items. Next, we will do a wrapped loop. A wrapped loop is very similar to the loop we have just made. You will again place your bead on the head pin, and we will still, with our needle nose pliers, make a 90 degree bend. But this time, you will come up a ways from the bead and leave a small gap. This way you have room for your wrap. Then, using your round nose pliers, again, we will make a wrap. But this time we're not going to cut off our excess because we need that to make our wrap. Now we're going to make our loop. Just bend the wire over the round nose pliers. You're going to go all the way around until that crosses. Now that we've got our loop, you're going to grab a hold of the loop with the needle nose pliers so it's covered all the way. And you can do this with your hand, or you can use another pair of pliers. We're just going to wrap around, and each wrap we're going to try and get it as close to the last wrap that we've just made. Go slow and steady. And once you get to the bead, once your last wrap hits your bead, you're gonna take your wire cutters and clip off your excess, like so. And I usually hold on to my loop and take another pair of needle nose pliers and just tuck that excess back down against the wrap until I have a nice little wrapped loop. And again, you can use this for earrings or any other kind of jewelry item. But if you're going to put this item directly onto an earring and you don't want to open the ear wire, you will have to put this on before you make the wrap, because this will not open on its own. Or you can attach it with a jump ring. If you're going to attach it with a jump ring, I will show you the correct way to open a jump ring. When opening a jump ring, you never want to pull it open like this. You're going to have a difficult time getting it closed. The correct way to open a jump ring is to twist it open. And that's also the correct way to close it. And you do want it to actually touch when it's closed. Now, if you do have a jump ring that's open the wrong way, you don't ever want to try to squeeze it closed. Usually you're gonna have the problem of squeezing it too far and it's going to overlap. So in that case, if it is open too far, the best thing to do is wiggle it closed. I actually give a little pressure inward and wiggle back and forth ever so slightly. You may have to adjust your grip again. But you'll see, even then, because the jump ring was open the wrong way, it was distorted into almost an oval shape. So it's not the best method to use. It's usually best if you open it the correct way the first time.